opening moves of Fukyugata Ni. This comes from Goju-ryu. Our system Matusbayashi uses that basic form from Goju-ryu. We call it Fukyugata Ni. So just a reminder, the opening sequence. So that's the opening sequence we're going to be reviewing. Now we've already looked at one possible application. Right? So quickly review, we were talking about how we're working off of a lapel grab. Most likely there's swings, so you want to jam that, keep them from attacking you. You're going to get off to the side, as the kata tells us, right? You hit the crook of the arm, thrust into the neck. He might cover that, so you want to hit a different target. So you hit down, step in, punch him in the head. It could be open hand, whatever you want. Yeah? If that doesn't drop him, he might decide to square up and strike again, in which case the kata says, go low. All right? So we're working the idea of attack high, shift your targets high and low based upon how they're reacting. So that was one application. The next application we're going to look at is the context is basically you've lost control of the fight. The arms are swinging, and you don't know what's happening. If you just constantly start swinging, if you just start covering and backing up, you're going to get hit at some point. So you have to do something. All right. So the kata is going to give us one possible strategy for how to deal with you're in the middle of a confrontation and you just sort of lose control of where it's at. Okay. So if you notice the kata, it's sometimes subtle depending on who's performing and what style, but basically, the first move, that right hand has to come up to do the windup for the high block, right? So what we're going to think of is that raising the hand is kind of like the things are flying, limbs are going, you're just going to stick the hands up, okay? So hands are up, all right. So I've got an idea of where it is. I got clocks, okay? It's going to happen, right? So the idea is, you've got your hands up. All right. Once that happens, it comes in, so I know where things are. I know where this arm is, right? So the kata says, get off to the side. I know where this is. That's kind of sort of thing, see? I know where this is. Get off to the side and wrap it up and start blasting him in the neck, okay? So that's similar to what we were doing with the lapel grab application. So I'm controlling this limb, and I'm blasting here, okay? So he may decide to cover, same thing. I'm going to switch the limb down. I want to get a different target. And one way to get a different target is to shift his body. Right? So there are two ways you can get to a target. You can either shift yourself in relation to the person, right? Or shift their body in relation to you. Yeah? So in order to get to the back of his head, I can either step around and hit, or I can use this movement here to twist his body. Now I've realigned his body in relation to me. So here, I can start blasting. Notice I shift here to control, hit his upper limb here. Right, so from hitting here, what his tendency is going to want to be to try and square up. So before he does that, I'm going to slip this arm up right here and get my hand in his lower back. What does that look like? What's the next move in a kata after that step punch? Right? You've got the wind up for the low block, right? So this around his throat, this hand in his lower back. Because if I just did this, he's going to take a step back, right? It's going to be hard to throw him. Because what I'm doing, I'm using that low block as a takedown, basically, right? So I've been hitting him here, this hand's coming up here, and I'm going to try and keep him from stepping back by jamming his hand into his hip. Okay? So that's going to be an important application of the windup. Now, notice on the second part of the kata, we've got the little extra slide in there that we only do on the one side. Various interpretations of that one, we talked about how it can be a leg sweep. This time we're going to use that extra slide back as a way to move quickly so that I'm going to move his upper body faster than his feet can follow. Right? Because if I just start moving slowly, his feet are going to go underneath and he's going to hold there, pull me, flip me, there's other. So I don't want that. So after I've struck here and I'm in here, to take him down, I'm going to basically do this, right? Pull him right down. Notice part of his body might hit my knee. That's fine. The spine, head hits the knee. Great. more damage on him. But we're going to do this slowly, right? So, because this is a mean fall. Basically, you're falling right back, okay? So what I want you to do for practice to make it safe on your partner, I want you to just kind of squat down and do the basic backward slap out that we've been working on, okay? So we're here. I'm going to slowly take that slide back. Down it goes, right? Strike, and you're out, okay? So the idea here is you're trying to get to his back. And there are a variety of ways. So for here, right, if I'm just getting to his back, now I've got this. I can do a choke or whatever if I want to. But remember, we talk about chokes. If there are other guys who might get involved here, I'm tied up with this guy trying to choke him out, and buddy's coming to start attacking me. So I'm not going to do a choke in this particular application. Instead, I'm going to get to his rear so I can take him down. And then here the kata says, control him here, and this slides straight back. And then I kind of held his head for safety. But in the street, I just throw him down. That head's hitting the floor or my knee or whatever. Right? So again, so we'll start the drill by just, so just do the swing, okay, from here. I'm going to get off to the side and start striking. All right? I'm going to move this limb to the side, strike to the back of his head, come right in, get this position. I've got my, almost like a choke here. Hand is lower back to keep it from stepping backwards, and then just slide that way as in the kata. But do this one slow. And now. Okay? Make sense?